Well, welcome everybody. I'm Steve Dilley. I'm one of the product managers working on the Aurora database at AWS. And today I'm super excited to be talking to you about how PGvector can help you AI enable your Aurora database. So we have a really simple agenda. So first I'll introduce you to what PGvector is and tell you how it works under the covers. Then I'll tell you what we are seeing as common PGvector use cases from customers. And last, I'll show you a quick demo of semantic search using PGvector and Aurora. So what is PGvector? PGvector is a PostgreSQL extension for storing vectors and performing vector similarity search. Well, what do vectors have to do with generative AI, you may be asking? So, well, it turns out that machine learning and foundation models represent text and images as mathematical vectors that a machine can search through and compare with other vectors. Now, these vectors are referred to as embeddings. You'll hear this term a lot. And this task of comparing embeddings is absolutely key in the deployment of machine learning for uses like similarity search of images or text. PGvector enables Aurora to store your embeddings and do comparisons using SQL on data in Aurora already or on data stored in other locations, such as S3, that are converted to embeddings and then loaded into Aurora. This enables you to deploy machine learning applications on data in your database without moving it and maintaining all the security and control that you're used to. Okay, that's what PGvector can do. But what are these embeddings and how do they work? Well, let's start by looking at text. Word and sentence embeddings are the bread and butter of foundation models, which are also called large language models. Now, the idea of a large language model is to get the computer to understand language. But language is in words, and computers only understand numbers. And embeddings are the bridge. Word embeddings associate words and their meaning with a list of numbers in a vector. Sentence embeddings do the same for sentences. Embedding refers to the process of using an LLM like BERT or Amazon's Titan foundation model to transform objects such as text, images, or video into numerical representations that reside in a high-dimensional vector space. So let's look at an example to understand how text is converted into an embedding. In this example, we see off to the left, we see cities, animals, and an airplane. Now, from their usage in sentences, the large language model algorithm derives semantic meaning for the words and creates vectors of numbers. So going by row here, these numbers have greater distance between them for dissimilar meaning words and less distance for similar meaning words. So in this example, we have cities, which can't move, having numbers that are greater distance from movable objects such as animals and planes. And the same holds true with the concepts of, say, concrete or old age, which apply to a city, but not to planes and animals. So I'm showing you three meanings in the columns, but these vectors are multidimensional and can have hundreds or thousands of columns to bring more nuanced meaning to the solution. Okay, so what about images? I thought this was really cool when I learned how this works. To give you an idea of how images are vectorized, here's an example of handwriting. Now, this data set that I'm showing here is called Minced, and it contains 70,000 handwritten digits, and these were written by high schoolers and census workers. This data was originally used by the post office for address recognition. So in this example, each written number is first processed into a 28 by 28 grayscale image, which you see off to the right. Now put away your calculators, everybody. 28 by 28 gives us a vector length of 784. Then the images are pixelized into binary, so there's either a 1 or a 0 in each vector location. Now let's look at how PGvector would determine similarity between these vectors. So if we conducted a query of a digit on the left from our application, and let's just say that digit is the number 5, this vector would be compared to the vectors stored in Aurora of all the handwriting digits to see what it is most similar to. Now, I made this example really simple. If the query on the left is the number 5, which vector looks most similar to the query, vector 1 or vector 2? Well, we as humans can tell by looking that vector 1 looks more similar to the query than vector 2, because vector 2 has so many 1s down the middle that vector 1 does not have. So it's a much closer match. Now, we determine this by eye, but the machine does it by math using similarity measures like Euclidean distance or cosine similarity that are supported by PGvector to spot the mathematically closest vector. Okay, now you have an idea about embeddings and vectors, but how can AWS help you generate the embeddings? We have Amazon Bedrock, which makes foundation models from Amazon and leading AI startups, including AI 21 Labs, Anthropic, and Stability AI, accessible via an API. Bedrock offers the ability to access a range of powerful foundation models for text and images, including Amazon's Titan models, through a serverless, scalable, reliable, and secure AWS managed service. We also have the SageMaker Jumpstart Marketplace for third-party AI models. Now, some of these are publicly available free models, which are shown on the left, and some are proprietary models that have a charge. You can choose models for your specific use cases based on whether they're trained on images or text, for example. And you can access all of these models through a SageMaker endpoint and store the embeddings in Aurora. Okay, so that's how it works inside. So let's look at some practical applications for PGvector in Aurora. So first, here's one. You can use Aurora PGvector embeddings for visual search in retail. Now, StyleSnap is an AI-powered feature available from Amazon since 2019 in certain markets that helps customers use a photograph or a screenshot to find products that inspire them. Behind the scenes, Amazon continually creates embeddings of the products that are part of StyleSnap. So when a customer uploads a picture of their friend's outfit, Amazon creates an embedding of that photo and uses similarity search to find similar looks in the catalog, and it presents them to the customer. Now that's pretty cool, and that's all done right in your database. And recommendations is another common use for embeddings. Now, researching products and services and reading reviews, I'm sure you all agree, takes a long time. So imagine you're hungry for some tacos al pastor, and you just found a good-sounding taqueria on a review site. But next to it, on your phone, is a recommendation for a taqueria that is closer to you that was provided by embedding similarity search underneath the covers. And the first review you see of that taqueria raves about the tacos al pastor. Well, how do you know that that one review is really a common opinion? Do you want to read through 30 more reviews comparing what people have to say? Well, instead, you could hit summarize, and the text associated with the taqueria embedding you just found could be sent to an LLM that has access to all of the reviews of the restaurant. The LLM can return to you a summary of all of those reviews about that restaurant, or even just the reviews just about tacos al pastor. This technique is what's called retrieval augmented generation, or RAG. RAG augments the foundation model's training with knowledge outside of the model. In this case, that knowledge is a proprietary database of reviews. So let's look at a typical architecture of semantic search with RAG, because this is really a very important use case. First, we use the embedding model to create vector embeddings for the content we want to index, shown on the left. This content can come from S3 or other repositories. The vector embeddings are inserted into Aurora using PGvector, with some reference to the original content the embeddings was created from. When the application issues a query, we use the same embedding model to create an embedding for the query. PGvector uses that embedding to query the database for similar vector embeddings. Now, I want to point out something really important that I mentioned in the last use case, and that is this retrieval augmented generation, or RAG. So foundation models are really large, and they're trained offline, making the model agnostic to any data that is created after the model was trained. Additionally, foundation models are trained on very general domain corpora, making them less effective for any domain-specific task. However, you can use retrieval augmented generation to retrieve data from outside a foundation model and augment your prompts by adding relevant retrieved data. Now, when you perform a semantic search of the embeddings, the original user question is appended with relevant context from similar documents within the knowledge library. Then this augmented prompt is then sent to the foundation model in SageMaker Jumpstart in this example, where text answers to the prompt are generated. To make this easier for you, we have added a SageMaker connector to Aurora called Aurora ML that lets you use SQL and make calls to an LLM that include your augmented data. This is available only in Aurora and not in any other version of PostgreSQL. Aurora ML provides a connection to SageMaker models from Aurora. Using SQL, you can write queries that combine columns in the database and also may include calls to any SageMaker endpoint, especially those that contain LLMs in this example. So Aurora ML lets you package up the additional content you want to add to your LLM's knowledge for retrieval augmented generation and include it in the call. You can do this in real time, but we recommend that you do this in advance and store summaries in the database for the fastest query response whenever possible. Okay, let's see it all in action with a demo. This is a semantic search with RAG chatbot that we're building for a customer for use by their agents in answering customer questions. This application allows us to upload various types of content into Aurora as embedding. So we see here we can upload PDFs, text from S3, YouTube videos, CSV, and PowerPoint. Now in the actual application, agents wouldn't have to individually upload this content. You would have a process that runs in the background to create your knowledge base for the content you want, but agents could add content to it if they wanted to. So in this example, let's just start with a PDF. So what I found yesterday was an Amazon WorkDocs developer guide, and we're going to upload that. Now WorkDocs is a collaboration system that we use at Amazon. So we're going to upload that guide. It's about 30 pages long, if I recall, and then we click process. Now while process is happening, this is where the embedding is created. And we wait for that embedding to be created, and then we can try it out. Okay, so the embedding is done. So now we can just ask a question of our knowledge base. So let's say, what is Amazon WorkDocs? Let's give it a try. Okay, this is a good answer. Amazon WorkDocs is used to synchronize a folder on your Mac and Windows desktop with your Amazon WorkDocs file. That's exactly what it does. It lets me share documents with other people that we can collaborate with. So we could keep asking questions of this, but I think it's more fun to move on and look at other content types too. So let's look at a video, because I think this is kind of a neat process. So what we do with video is we take a YouTube link. So yesterday I found a YouTube video from AWS about cloud computing. So we put the link in here and then we hit process and embedding is created again. So in this case, let's see, let's ask it a question now. So what's happened here is the audio was taken from the video, turned into text, and then an embedding was created from that text. So let's ask a question from this video about what is cloud computing, for example, since that's what it's about, and see what kind of an answer we get. Cloud computing is the on-demand delivery of IT resources via the internet. That's perfect. That sounds like cloud computing to me. So I hope this gives you a feel for how powerful LLMs are and what a productivity boost they can be for your use case. So for a quick recap of today's session, PGvector is a PostgreSQL extension that allows you to store text, image, and other data types as vectors in your database called embeddings. The killer app we see from our customers is similarity search of text and images. Retrieval augmented generation allows you to add proprietary knowledge to foundation models without retraining them. And Aurora ML makes it easier to connect your database to your LLM in SageMaker today. And it also allows you to add sentiment and text summarization from other models to your similarity search results. Well, that's it for today. We can't wait to see what you build with PGvector. So have a great day and be sure to get in touch. And you can see my email address on the screen if you want to talk about what you're going to do with PGvector. Thanks a lot.